Wow, I don't know what's going on.
Oh, it's an earthquake.
Huh?
It was an earthquake.
How do you know?
Because the tires went a little funny. I thought, oh, maybe the road is just funny. It kind of wiggled.
Of course, people driving near the epicenter were caught off guard.
That is a big earthquake.
Geologists, not so much.
In the scheme of things, it's a pretty ordinary quake.
The Sierra's been doing this kind of thing for 10 million years, one magnitude 6 at a time.
Where it happened is one of the most tectonically active parts of the country, and it's no surprise that it happened there.
It's one reason the Eastern Sierra is loaded with bubbling mud pots and volcanoes.
So this is kind of the fundamental mechanism that, for instance, created Badwater Basin, in Death Valley.
Exactly. It makes some of the most iconic topography that our state and country has.
What we really should think about are the recent little quakes lighting up the Hayward Fault back home in the Bay Area.
Does your eyebrow raise at all when you see those magnitude fours on Hayward and think maybe this is part of a foreshock to the one we inevitably expect?
It's a great question, and it's frankly great that your mind goes there, because any earthquake that we experience here should be a reminder that the big one can happen at any time.
The Hayward Fault last snapped in 1868, and when it snaps again?
Yeah, it's an earthquake. That was an earthquake.
It'll be 30 times stronger than Thursday's quake.
And the shaking is going to be pretty dramatic. A Hayward Fault presents one of the most threatening scenarios for an earthquake in the country, and in fact, sort of in the world. It is one of the most urbanized and heavily developed over faults.